The lower lumbar spine is where many disc injuries occur, but it's also where we get a lot of facet sprains. And in some of the testing, we can figure out what do you have and not have to go get an MRI. So for example, with a lumbar facet sprain, it's going to hurt when I raise the leg, but it's going to stay pretty localized to that low back. You'll let me raise the leg and the pain might shoot a little bit into the glutes to the upper hamstring, but it won't go past the knee. Many times a disc will go all the way past the knee. Second thing is if I pull the toe back, a disc injury is going to hurt more and the pain will probably shoot down the leg further. It won't make a difference on a facet sprain. If I bend the knee, turn it, move it around, a facet sprain is probably going to hurt a little bit more, localize that low back. A disc injury isn't going to change that much at all. Holding the legs up in the air is going to hurt a facet and a disc, but the facet's going to stay and be much more intense. And likewise, as I lower the legs down, you'll probably feel more pain with a facet than a disc injury. So these are things that help differentiate a facet sprain versus a lumbar disc.